into a position in which they had no choice but to attack. They did this by cutting off Japan's access to raw materials needed for its war against China. The United States policy created the conditions whereby the Japanese would attack in order to take the supplies they needed by force. The Roosevelt administration had already cracked the Japanese military codes and must have known weeks in advance of Japanese planned attack. On December 7, 1941, a date that the President Franklin D. Roosevelt claimed would live in infamy, the Imperial Japanese Navy conducted a surprise aerial assault on Pearl Harbor. This unprovoked attack brought the United States into World War II, as it immediately declared war on Japan. Pearl Harbor was and still is the most important American naval base in the Pacific and home to the U.S. Pacific Fleet. It is located on the Hawaiian island of Oahu. The background of Japan's attack is that Japan at the time wanted to make a more powerful and advanced government and military. Since they wanted to become more powerful, Japan decided to expand their power, so they decided to go after the Pacific region near China and Korea. As the Japanese grew bolder, the U.S. began to push back. Roosevelt banned the sale of steel, scrap iron, and oil to Japan. Roosevelt also demanded that the withdrawal of Japanese troops from China. Lastly, Roosevelt made a move that threatened the Japanese. The U.S. was going to relocate from San Diego, California to Pearl Harbor, Hawaii. That put the fleet 2,500 miles closer to Japan. Japanese leaders then began to devise a plan to prevent the U.S. Navy from interfering with Japan's great scheme. The Japanese would then launch their surprise attack on the U.S. fleet at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii. However, Japan lacked the natural resources to make a reality, with all but 6% of its oil being imported. After capturing Manchuria, Japan became bogged down in a full-scale war with China in 1937, and had to look elsewhere for resources it needed to fight. Meanwhile, the U.S. was slowly awakening from its isolationism when Japan occupied France and Indochina in 1941. America retaliated by freezing all Japan's assets in the States, preventing Japan from purchasing oil, having lost 94% of its oil supply and unwilling to submit to U.S. demands. Japan planned to take the oil needed by force, however, striking south into British Malaya and the Dutch East Indies would almost certainly provoke an armed U.S. response. To blunt that response, Japan decided to attack the U.S. Pacific Fleet at Pearl Harbor, hoping that the U.S. would negotiate peace. The attack on Pearl Harbor was a huge gamble, but one which most did not pay off. Though Japan took its objectives into the Pacific and Southeast Asia, the U.S. did not respond as expected. Instead of reverting into isolationism, the U.S. geared up for total war against Japan.
The immediate result of our topic was the U.S. made internment camps for Japanese people in the U.S. The relocation centers, also called internment camps, were a place where four or five families with their sparse collections of clothing and possessions shared tar-papered army-style barracks. Most of these families lived in these conditions for nearly 3 years or more until the end of the war. In early February 1942, the War Department created 12 restriction zones along the Pacific coast and established nighttime curfews for Japanese Americans within them. Individuals who broke curfew were subject to immediate arrest. On March 31, 1942, Japanese Americans along the West Coast were ordered to report to control stations and register their names of all family members. The bombing of Pearl Harbor is a U.S. naval base near Honolulu, Hawaii, that was the scene of a devastating surprise attack by Japanese forces on December 7, 1941. Just before 8 a.m. on that Sunday morning, hundreds of Japanese fighter planes descended on the base, where they were managed to destroy or damage nearly 20 American naval vessels, including 8 battleships and over 300 airplanes. Japanese Admiral Isoroku Yamamoto conceived the Pearl Harbor attack, and Captain Minoru Genda planned it. Japanese was over Pearl Harbor at exactly 7:55 when they first striked. the Japanese have over 200 aircrafts ready to attack. When they first started the attack, the Japanese went straight for the ships in the harbor because they were the perfect target. The U.S. only had time to get 6 planes up in the air. Next, the second wave began at 8:50 a.m., and Japan destroyed more battleships and destroyers. After that, the U.S. began to fight back and knock down a lot of planes. Lastly, Japan retreated and lots of people died. The Japanese attack killed 2,403 U.S. personnel, including 68 civilians. The short-term effect on Pearl Harbor was on December 8th, President Franklin Delano Roosevelt asked Congress for and received a declaration of war against Japan. On December 11th, Germany and Italy, allied with Japan, declared war on the U.S. and the United States had entered World War II. While the nation may have assumed Japan was going to be the first priority, there were 2 major differences between the Pacific and the European theaters. Adolf Hitler's forces had captured considerable territory in Europe, which passed a greater immediate threat to the world than Japan's conquest of Asian territories. With much of Europe and the Atlantic under Nazi control, the United States was at risk of being the next target. If those concerns weren't enough, the United States had been urged by the United Kingdom to join the war against the Axis from the beginning of the conflict. Even if the U.S. had intended to assist the Chinese first, the British were considered better equipped to put up a fight against Germany. The reason U.S. entered World War II was because Japan bombed the U.S. at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, and the U.S. got mad because Japan did this attack out of the open. The U.S. got warnings but ignored it and thought it was a false alarm. Hawaii felt humiliated. Lastly, to get back at the Japanese, the U.S. dropped 2 atomic bombs. World War II came to the United States of America on Sunday morning, December 7th, 1941, with a massive surprise attack by the Imperial Japanese Navy, like a thunderclap from the sky. Japanese carrier attack planes in both torpedo and high-level bombing roles, supported by fighters, numbering 353 aircraft from 6 aircraft carriers, attacked from the U.S. Pacific Fleet at Pearl Harbor in 2 waves. As well as nearby naval and military airfields and bases, the enemy sank 5 battleships and damaged 3 heavy cruisers, 3 light cruisers, 2 destroyers, 2 seaplane tenders, 2 repair ships, and a destroying tenders. This topic is very important in history because it decimated the U.S. Pacific Fleet and left lots of U.S. citizens in horror. Then, on December 11th, 1941, Italy and Germany declared war on the United States, and then America was found in World War II. It was a turning point because it caused the United States to enter war even though they didn't want to. The reason Japan bombed Pearl Harbor was because it could severely cripple the U.S. fleet and buy them time in the Pacific and Southeast Asia. Each year, on December 7th, Americans pay tribute to the brave veterans who saved their lives for our freedom. God bless America.